If you guys don't know, the Bleach Blu-rays are finally out, and if you haven't watched my video from yesterday, we talked about the little special editions and notes from Kubo and the staff themselves in regards to some extra few little tidbits within the Bleach Blu-ray and its little contents inside. So please, I do recommend you go check that out, because in this video, we're going to be talking about the one-to-one comparisons of the broadcast version, things that you've seen on TV or your streaming services, and the differences between this Blu-ray box set and why it's worth your money, and also about Kubo's comments and the staff in general. So let's get into it, because this is a really, really cool one. So as I said, this video is about a comparison, and before I get into this comparison, I just want to give a quick little thought before I start giving my reaction on some images. By the time I got to around the 200 images mark of this video, I kind of just gave up, because you guys will have gotten the point, and it's probably going to be scattered all over online as well. This is going to be strictly pictures and not video, so it helps with copyright, but also no one's really uploaded any of the footage as well. So yeah, you're going to have to deal with images for now. And some images we might even need context towards. But again, we'll discuss that when we get into things. But I do want to say I do appreciate the fact that Bleach as a production, as what we saw on TV and on streaming services, looked immaculate when it came to direction, when it came to cinematography, colours, sound, even special effects and CGI all looked fantastic in their own right. So the idea that there is like literally over 500 corrections within this Blu-ray box set as it is, and probably even more, is astounding to me, because even when you look at these corrections, like, you'll notice them and you'll be like, oh wow, I didn't notice that the first time I watched it, or the 10th time that I watched it. And I think that that speaks volumes towards the production itself. Bleach on its own without these corrections stood on its own feet and looked absolutely immaculate and perfect as it was. So the fact that they were able to do these corrections is really impressive, to say the least. Like, really, Bleach looked gorgeous, and it only looks even better in these images. However, before I get into that, I do want to give just a message towards Kubo's comment. Well, I found out that there were a lot of picture corrections in the Blu-ray disc of the Millennium Blood War arc, and when I checked with the director, he didn't know exactly what was going on, and it turned out that the staff on site had voluntarily corrected a lot of things that they didn't agree with because they didn't have time when the film was in broadcast. The love is amazing. And there you have it. I think it is very commendable for the fact that even though Taguchi didn't make these kind of corrections kind of a priority or even mention it so it would seem, the fact that the team themselves obviously have the creative freedom to do something like this, but also the care and passion that they have for Bleach. And I think that speaks absolute volumes towards the series. The correct staff that Taguchi has picked up is clearly a staff that is, I guess, one that is passionate about the series that they are working on. And again, I wish more series at Piro had more to do with this, like with their series. Whether Black Clover or Boruto had the same treatment for out of love and passion is another question, but for Bleach, it's definitely set in stone right now that Kubo has elaborated that this is a voluntarily thing, and they really love it, and they wanted to make sure that it was perfect for not only us, but for, you know, the fans and the viewers and themselves as well, and their own creative liberty as well. And I think, again, that speaks volumes. So I want to give a big shout out to all the people that worked on the show, obviously, as well as doing the corrections. And we can't thank you and appreciate you enough for the care that you've put into the series that we love and enjoy. So with that being said, let's get into the corrections. Now, with these corrections, you're going to notice things that are very small and very significant as well. And I've just gone and collected a bunch of ones that I found at least significant, or things that I want to talk about. So one, this is a face that I kind of wanted changed. I didn't really like it that much within episode 8. Episode 8 had a lot of problems, to say the least, but I'm glad that they actually fixed Soifon's face. And as you can see, is the TV version, is the Blu-ray version. I'm glad that they actually fixed Soifon's face, because this looked weird and I didn't like it, and it looked kind of pathetic for Soifon in some sort of sense. But at least this one looks a bit more like an angry shocked more than anything, so it keeps in contrast with her personality as well as her reaction within the state of this scene in particular. So I'm glad that they fixed her porn face, I guess you could say. So there you go, that looks a lot better and a lot cleaner. Next off, we have something a little bit insignificant, I would say, like things like moving the vessel which is holding Tenzan Zangetsu. Again, a lot of the shots you're going to see are about camera perspective, so things like this, switching switching this is just completely fine, and I appreciate it. They didn't need to do it. I don't think anyone would have noticed or cared or critiqued it, but again, it's the little details like this that I appreciate. Next off is Ichigo. I believe that this is like an added like second or an added little millisecond of cut, so nothing too special going on here. Then we have the Kurinji scene with the springs. This is just added blood, not added blood, but more so given a sense of realistic blood in steam and water where it's kind of faded out within the skin a little bit. And the same with this image as well, just adding a little bit of extra blur effect and smudging effect, which you would get from a hot spring or burns, I guess you could say, rather than blood. It looks more like burnt blood, I guess. So yeah, this makes a lot more sense. And again, nice little attention to detail. Next off, we have an amazing fight with Kenpachi and Unohana. You're going to get a lot of steals between this and Yamamoto versus Yuha as well. But first and foremost, Unohana getting more like of a color difference within the Muken, giving it more of a darker contrast, which is, again, I'm fine with this. No problems here. And I think same with this as well, giving a nice little reflection towards the sword as well, which again, taking away some of the lines on the cracks of Kenpachi's sword. But again, yeah, I do enjoy the corrections a little bit more. This one as well is kind of the same. However, there is a correction with Unohana. Now, granted, this picture of Unohana is fine until you look at the correction and you're like, oh, she looks even better. Her forehead got bigger, but the glistening of her hair, the reflections of the crystals behind her gives it a better sense of depth, as well as correcting her face and eyes, more so her eyes and nose in this perspective. So, and even her lips to some degree as well. So again, keeping on model and just tidying her up a little bit. Again, appreciated nonetheless. Same with this one as well. I believe that, yeah, this is just a color diff and again, reflections of the crystals. I think the fight in general was really, really dark. So to add these highlights is definitely going to be easier on the eyes to watch, especially because again, unless you're in a dark room, you're not really going to be able to appreciate this as much, especially if you're watching it in broad daylight as well. So again, nice little highlights to kind of accentuate the characters here. This one as well, Cindy's, I believe Cindy's cut this was, and just again, lighting differences. I wouldn't have minded either way with this correction. Again, unlike the shadow effect that they added to Unohana's feet and also her Shinigami robes, a bit of shadow there, I like that. But again, the guy running towards her, I don't think it needed to be a correction, but hey, nonetheless, like it, no problems there. We have Unohana again. This is going to be a correction on the art and face, and again, I think Unohana just looks a lot better here. Again, the fact that like this is even past, this is very passable. I had no issues with this. I didn't even pick up that there was an issue here. But again, the fact that they go back and they fix up her eyes and her mouth is great here. I love that. This one's a bit of an interesting one because even though it's more so on the sword and putting more detail in texture of the sword, which again, you're going to see a lot of that. Also, it seems that they kind of differentiated and kind of toned down the rain or blood kind of splatter on screen. So I'm assuming that that is the case here. But again, the sword, nice little attention to detail, and you're just going to see a lot of that again here. Blood, more texture on the blood, more darkness in the Shinigami robes, and it seems like a feet fix as well. So yeah, like no problems here either, just little touch-ups, which again, nice. Same with Unohana's face and arm, it would seem here as well. So again, little touch-ups here, nothing too special. Same again here, difference in facial structure as well as color diff as well. Unohana's bankai, well, when she's about to say bankai and she's about to go into keto, what's going to change here is highlights of the hair. Again, great addition. Seems like she actually has an outline. Again, Muken is very dark, so you're going to see a lot of highlights being added in these scenes. Unohana's bankai, I feel like this is the same as well, and this is okay. The eyes are changing, she's looking more towards the camera again. I can't wait to see this in motion, because I feel like a lot of the speed, a lot of frames are going to be added as well, and a lot of differences, because there's one where there's some blood added as well, and yeah, some color differences as well. So this is it. I believe this is it, where they add blood here. So there's definitely going to be some interesting motion added here. So I'm very excited to see that. And of course, the contrast and the brightness has been toned up as well. And it seems like a bit of camera movement here. So I assume a faster panning shot, I would imagine. So again, I am going to waffle on here with the same sort of stuff, but it's just to give you guys a nice interesting look into what Bleach is going to be looking like within the Blu-rays. This one, I can't remember in context, but again, it's a bloody fight anyway. So then removing the blood of Kenpachi here, again, I can't remember specifically what happens in this scene, specifically whether Kenpachi got hit or not, but they definitely toned up Kenpachi's face, made it more rugged and fixed up his eyes as well. So again, things that you don't notice, but until you do, until they're corrected. So again, nice little things here. Again, unless you're an anime watching, you make your job out of nitpicking, you wouldn't really notice this. at all. So again, these are lovely fixes, especially on the nose here. Yeah, I can see with the nose, they definitely fixed up on that, and the eyes. Another one of Unohana here doing a swiping attack. It just seems that they touched up the definition of the blood as well as the highlights in the eyes. Nothing too special here, just seems like a color and brightness diff. This one here, they added a lot of whatever those are. I can't actually remember what this is. Is this just like pieces of like dried up blood, like falling? Again, it's a nice addition. I've got no issues here, and they seem to have added like little particles falling as well. Kenpachi here going in for a downward slash. I believe that this is a movement reanimation, not reanimation, but repositioning. So that's nice. Unohana here again, light indifference, removing some of the shadowings of the eyes, making it more seen towards the viewer. And there's a line also on Unohana's lip that gets removed as well. So a little bit of an error there that's been removed. So again, nice touch. We'll get back into the past versus Unohana versus Kenpachi. Again, detail on the sword has been added, with there being some blur on the blood itself and some colouring differences as well. Kenpachi here, I don't really see an issue here until you see the next image, and it seems like there's been a brightness difference and also a mouth fix there as well, as well as some of the shadowing on Kenpachi's arm flaps too, like the Shinigami robe. So that's nice. This one as well, I believe I didn't like this transition. Maybe I said it in the live reaction of the review, but I didn't quite like this transition. So hopefully this has been fixed as well to make it a bit more smoother. But I'm glad that this clearly has had a change. And also this really cool like film effect. I don't know what it's called. Like it's like this lens flare effect that they've got going on. I like that. And you'll see that a few times within these images as well. Kenpachi here has blood on his shoulder instead of like a highlight. So that's been fixed. And also some darkness around them, which again fits with the Mukan and the surroundings. Unohana here looks great. The fact that they fix this, I don't think really needed to be fixed, but it seems like they fixed like the highlights in her hair and some blood on her lip as well as the jawline. Again, both look great, and I have no issues whatsoever with any of these pictures. Namaya gets so much justice within these corrections. I don't know what happened in this episode with Namaya, but you will notice just Namaya in general just gets fixed so much. Like nobody really mentioned it, but Namaya had some baby hands. Like he had some, like you'll see it, and the puffer jacket will have more definition, and his arms will have more definition. You're about to see it now. 3, 2, 1, boom. Looks so much different. Look at the puffer jacket, look at the Shinigami robes. He's a lot more thicker, his arms are more defined, his face is more defined. So I'm glad, and his hands, of course. You'll see his hands just throughout just always get changed, but I'm glad that Namaya really got a well-deserved fix. And you'll see it here too. Look at the hands, puffer jacket too. Again, it's the little details like that which really add a lot of depth and a lot of personality into a character. So again, fixing the Mario up, he got a lot of justice. And boys, if you didn't see on Twitter, at me, James Hansen, you will see on Twitter that I posted this, and the girls got a vamp, boys, because 3, 2, 1, sheesh, come on, some definition, some shadowing, and some of the girls got thicker. Look at that. Some of them got thicker. So we won, boys. We won. Again, same here. Interesting enough, these two girls got... Wait, were they... Okay. Okay. So these two get, like, removed for some reason. Again, I don't really want to check the manga because I feel like it's so insignificant, but Ichigo's hair and face gets changed a lot here. Ichigo's face gets changed a lot as well. Renji, not so much. There was just no love for Renji. But it seems that, like, yeah, Ichigo got fixed a lot, and Ichigo's hair gets fixed, and obviously his eyes as well, so that's cool. Baby arms, Namaya, and Ichigo's face, I believe, in this one. Again, a lot better. The shading, Ichigo looks a lot more like Ichigo. It looks like Kubo's art style, and again, Namaya gets fixed as well. And this one, look at the arms. No, sorry, the hands. Look at the hands, man. Look at the hands. Fixed. Look at that. Beautiful. So Ichigo looks great there as well. Fantastic. Shading's great. I love that. This one, again, I'm not really bothered by this. I guess it makes more sense to have the hand behind the back of the head. Same with Namaya here. I believe there isn't really much of a change here. Oh yeah, except for his nails. The nail colouring. That's fine. Namaya looks great here. Ichigo, this is one of my favourites because this really hits the nail on the head for Kubo's art style when it comes to comedic moments. So you're going to see, there you go, an Ichigo that looks like it's straight from the manga. And I really like this image a lot. You can also see a slight bit of shading on Renji's teeth as well. But other than that, like the grip of his shoulder and just this is just a Kubo-esque drawing if I've seen it. And I love this correction. Overall, I think it's just 10 times better. This one as well, again, this is going to be a Kubo-esque type change as well. And that looks like a shocked Ichigo face. And that looks like a Renji shocked face. And again, a lot better. There's more color in Renji's hair as well. Bandana looks better. So again, this scene looks great here. And we're only halfway there, believe it or not. And this one, again, is so much better as well. And I can't believe, like, I didn't even notice this. This is how good the anime was, is that you just don't even notice. Maybe some of you guys did, but look at the difference between this shot and like this. Look at the Zabimaru and look at the Tenzan Zangetsu. Just absolutely so much better. The hands more defined on Uetsu. And this is a big change. I love this a lot. Like, again, in the manga, that's how it looked like. In the anime, I didn't even realize it looked like that because it was just like such a quick frame. But again, the fact that they put the attention to detail, I appreciate a lot. This fight as a whole, I'm interested to see the overall fight because some cuts were a bit weird. But again, position difference on here and a bit of fire difference as well. Yeah, just little things like that. Same here as well. It seems like there's a transitional difference here. So I wonder if it's a lot more smoother or a lot more impactful when Aizen hits Isshin in the back. Again, this as well. I didn't even notice this, but there was no blood when White actually bit into Misaki, which there should have been. So I don't know why I missed that. But again, it's these little details that make a difference. And this one is a camera difference. Yeah, this one's a camera difference of perspective. Perspective is better. So again, I appreciate that. No one would have really noticed, but the fact that the animation team do is really much appreciated and shows how much attention to detail they put into these. This is probably one of the biggest ones, and I don't think we're going to get into these right yet, but I put this just as a nice little landmarker. This is interesting because obviously Yuha looks way different. And this is more resembling towards Tenza Zangetsu, obviously the Zangetsu that we know. Now, people are theorizing that the animation team didn't do this in the broadcasting because they didn't want to spoil that it was Tenza Zangetsu or Old Man Zangetsu from Ichigo's world. And honestly, I don't think that this was the case at all. I just think that this was an addition that they wanted to add. I don't think this was ever like a thought process within Taguchi's or Kubo's mind. I think that this was a complete creative decision, and it's one that I love as well because it's extremely consistent. When I said on Twitter like that, I was like, wait, what? Like, I wasn't complaining, I was just shocked. Like, it's such a dramatic change for them to do that, and I was just shocked. And as I go through the other images, like, it just looks really good, because at first you're just like, you're shell-shocked essentially, because like, you're just seeing something that you feel like you shouldn't be seeing, and like, it's such a dramatic change that like, you have to kind of retrain your brain into getting used to how a character looks. But as you go for the other images, you'll see that it fits really nicely. Another one of Ichigo, this is towards the last episode, just more corrections on Ichigo's face, no issues here, same here, looks more like Kubo's art here, which I like. It looks almost like Kazuya a little bit, I don't know. But yeah, I like this Ichigo here. This is a lot better of a drawing. Then we have Toshiro, more definition in the hair, again, always appreciated. They didn't need to do it, I didn't think like there was a problem, but again, cool. Mashiro, I didn't even notice a problem with Mashiro, and then I look at the correction and she just looks way better. The hair looks nice, her face looks more on character, what's it called, like the neck ribbon thing, like that looks, it just looks more fuller, and like, I didn't even notice until obviously these corrections. And it's nice, the fight from 1,000 years ago, here you go, we get to see Yuha with the new beard, as you guys probably just saw. And again, we're just seeing images of his new beard, which is nice. And also to mention as well that they tried to make him look a lot younger, obviously, but you can see the lines have decreased on his face a little bit, so it doesn't look as sagging, looks a little bit more youthful. Same with the nose a little bit too. So they've tried to make Yuha look a lot more youthful, which is really interesting as well. But same here, you can see the lines on his face as well, he looks a lot more chatty. But yeah, you got that. That's a big correction as well, that almost looks like it's completely redrawn almost. And then you see that as well. Again, it's getting used to these short beard Yuha, and I can't wait to actually rewatch that fight to see how it's all gonna look. And then as well, just corrections on the faces, I appreciate this a lot. Same here, I think I prefer that one, the TV version, but that's fine too. Again, this fight was amazing. There's not actually many corrections with this fight besides like filtering, background, and effects. So as you can see, more rain, darker background, so you can see, you know, the rain better. I like the lens flare here. This is a big one. I really like this. Just, I think it just sets a different set of environments. So again, I can't wait to see this one as well. And with this one, you kind of just throw more highlight towards the sword and put in more sense of a closeness. So I like this one a lot. This one's just kind of funny. The rock got some detail. I don't know. It just reminds me of like those old Dragon Ball days, like where you knew that a rock was going to get destroyed because it just had a different texture than every other rock in the series, like back in the 90s. So like, this is funny to me. And I think that's why I included it, because again, the attention to detail is nice. If you didn't watch the last video where we talked about Reishi and the different colors of Ryatsu, I suppose you could say, this is one of those, maybe potentially one of those examples of it where they've changed the yellow from like a black here. And you'll also see as well, I did take another screenshot where it is blue and red as well. But again, there's more texture, I think, in the rocks here and the background. And this, I remember doing the thumbnail for this and it was just so blue saturated, and I'm glad that they fixed this, because not only is there detail in the rocks, which I didn't actually notice before, that's really cool, gives it a lot more depth, but also the texture of the blue looks a lot better too. It doesn't look the same, it has a bit of tone to it. So I like this of the blue. It feels like the energy source is coming from somewhere. So like, this looks great. Like, I appreciate this change. It looks a lot better and it's not oversaturated with blue. With this, it's detail on the sword. Things that are just minimal, but I like it. This one is interesting as well because we have, obviously, Yamamoto burning the three stone ritter. They're all going down together, but in the next shot, they're falling down at different rates. So, again, can't wait to rewatch that scene, see how much different it is. Then we have, again, the past going back and seeing the beard, as we talked about, just getting, you know, used to seeing the beard again. And this is just lighting differences. I did hear some people complained about the lighting differences, kind of toning down or dulling down some of the colors. I personally don't see an issue in it. I think it looks great. This one as well, for the Bankai of Yamamoto, I definitely feel the difference here of making it more scoldering or more like black on the sword or charcoal really goes to show how hot this thing is, and keeping, I guess, his kind of scalded kind of charcoaled sword in consistency, I guess you could say. So I like this change. I don't mind either or, but it's a nice touch. I think it goes to show more fluidity within that flame that maybe was a bit oversaturated with the red and the yellow in the back. So again, and this one's awesome as well. I love just the added texture that they added to the floor here as well. So again, fire is hot, and hot is white. So the hotter something is, the whiter it is, because of how much it's burning and how much light it's emitting. So again, I like this a lot too. This is very much to physics. And I like this as well, adding texture. Very nice. And of course, taking away the shadow from the feet a little bit, because again, like, you've got light all around you. You don't need that much shadow. And this as well, people are saying this is resembling to one of the color pages within the manga. I'll try and put it up if I see a good quality of it. But yeah, again, yeah, it's the little differences. I like it. I do like it, to be fair. I got no hate towards it. This one as well, I'm actually impartial about this because I prefer the TV version. I do think the blue kind of overpowers and makes it look a bit more not fiery from Yamamoto a little bit. I prefer that, where that the fire's kind of blended in. But like this looks too what's it called, sharp, if that makes sense. But again, no issues whatsoever. I think it looks fine. Again, I took these just so you guys can get used to seeing like the shorter face Yuha, and again, the lighting differences of just showing more of the characters, more so than being too dark in the background. This one apparently has some people more so negative towards than actually positive. I don't mind it personally. Well, I don't think it's like a killer for me, the red eyes or the black eyes. I feel like it works. I feel like the red eyes definitely do like have this demonic presence, but the skeletons with the dark eyes have like this empty presence as well. So they both give off a different kind of a feeling, and I think they both work. Again, it just depends on how you guys feel, or when you watch the context of it in the actual footage itself when it comes out. I think that will change some of your guys' opinions, but again, I'm on the fence. I like them both. No issues here for me personally. Again, another one of Yuha with his shaven beard. Again, I really liked this addition, the lens flare and the added circles of the badge that I keep forgetting the name of, the one that steals the bonkers. I like this. This definitely gives off more detail and more going on. There's just more power behind it, and I like it a lot. Same with this one, corrections here, showing, you know, the badge, which I liked. The cross should have been black when it was absorbing abilities, which I'm glad that they fixed upon. Yamamoto here, again, he's an old man. He's got a lot of wrinkles and a lot of shading. So I'm glad that they added a lot more depth to not only his eyes, his reaction, but also his skin and texture as well. And oh, I love this so much because, yeah, his eyes are red here, but it gives that, they really add to the eyes here to show you this evil-ish look on Yuha's face, and it's fantastic. Yamamoto again, his death scene. This one looked like empty, but this one looks like acceptance in a sense. Again, the detail to the forehead, the detail and the shadow winds of under his eyes and whatnot. I like this. I like this change a lot more. There's a lot more feeling going on here. And especially under the bags of the eyes too. There's a lot more depth there as well. This one, I didn't realize there was a correction here, but apparently his shoulder's supposed to be black, which obviously makes sense. He's not wearing a Shinigami cloak, captain's cloak. And they've made the blood white, which again I guess adds on to, yeah, definitely adds to the melancholy effect. I think I said that right? Yeah, adds on. This one, it was a funny one that everyone noticed, and that was Komamura. This is going back like 100 years ago, 110 years ago, and this is Komamura without his like head guard on, even though like Aizen and Gin are there. And like Komamura is just there with his full bring outfit on, which is funny. So to have them change the with the bucket was a lot better. I'm glad that they fixed that. That everyone noticed that. So that one wasn't, I'm glad that they fixed it. And this is the last one that I'll show. And this is not really something I wanted to do individuals on. This looks like exactly the same. And it seems that they've just changed like Kurage's ability, not ability, but like the glow of his sword a little bit here. As well as like the back of his Volstandig as well. Some of it's like, just they've done a lot of color change and I'm excited. To be fair, there's not many screenshots of like episode 3. So I hope that they've changed. I mean, going by the screenshots that we've seen, it seems that they've gone back and have changed a lot. So I'm excited to see what episode 3 and 4 look like. I know that like episode 4 has had a lot of changes as well. There were just like more so some redraws and some color changes as well, which again, these episodes have been touched upon, but this is the only screenshot I have of episode 3. So I'm very interested to see, you know, what they fixed, because I think this was the most weakest and most damaged episode of the season, based on production wise. So I'm interested to see what they salvaged from it. With that being said, tell me your guys' thoughts on all of these screenshots, and what do you think? Is the Blu-ray worth buying? I think the answer is pretty much yes. I just wanted to talk about some of these screenshots, and I think it is absolutely aspiring to see some of this stuff, and I'm excited to see the footage. And I can't thank the team enough for fixing something that realistically we didn't realize needed fixing. The only thing I expected for them to fix, I think, was like episode 3 and 4, just to tidy them up. I didn't actually expect the other episodes to have such a dramatic treatment. I'll leave it off with that. Tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. If you haven't already, please hit that like and subscribe. I always appreciate it. With that being said, peace out.